actually, preparing for this presentation was incredibly depressing. Because it's just very hard to talk about happiness, right? And I suddenly realized why so many comedians got depressed. But today, I will make sure you have something to take away. Last winter, for me, it's all about gloomy weather, finals of not so exciting classes, and others are pretty happy on Facebook. And the entire I don't really know why I'm here. And I feel so unhappy that I started to doubt whether have I ever been happy here. So as a Blue student, I started to collect some evidence, some data points, to see whether I can reject the null hypothesis. And I came up with like 5 to 6 moments. It's not many, but enough for me to persuade myself that I have been happy here, and I felt better. And after that, I just continued this practice. Every time I felt wholeheartedly happy, I felt my life is worth it. And I felt if I die at the moment, I will conclude that my life is a good one. I write these moments down. I've got 73 moments on my list now during the past 5 months. And today I'm going to share with you the insights from the analysis of this data set. But before that, before the main dish, let's have some appetizers. So this time I'm asking my friend another awkward question. It's pretty much a challenge to my friend, huh? The question is, where do you get happiness? It's a real simple but really hard question. Is there anyone here want to give a shot?
Sure, with your friends, hanging out with your friends.
Okay, great. This is the first answer. Let me show you 8 of the answers I got. Of course, party is a big thing here. By the way, are you going to Spring Fling tonight? Great, I'll see you there. And we've got other people who just enjoy not crazy, not excited. Be calm. This is Eric Underwood, by the way. And also, we've got some foodies who enjoy and gain happiness from a bowl of ramen on a cold, rainy day. Oh, by the way, recently I realized that it's just so hard to not talk about weather in Chicago. And we've also got some antisocial kids who really prefer no one knows them. And also, when my wife got pregnant, this is Anderson. Yeah, sure. What is even more exciting than expecting a new baby? Well, when he is not expected. Fine. This is Joey. He was a professional pilot before business school. And he said, happiness to him is the ability to see the world from a different perspective. That's pretty cool. People gain happiness from constant achievements, while other people don't give it a shit. They love doing nothing. People are just so different, and that's beautiful. That's what makes this world so fascinating. And let's come to my data now. I break down my 73 moments into 11 categories, and 40% of my moment, my happiness, come from 2 sources. Can't wait, right? Let's start from the middle. Travel, all right? I'm still new in this country and traveling to Seattle, San Francisco, Nashville, New Orleans, Indianapolis, and Jackson Hole are all fun. Self-reflections. I get many aha moments when I'm doing self-reflections. It's very hard to describe the feeling. Maybe the closest feeling is orgasm. Make positive impact on people. I love that. Jokes, good jokes are sticky. I hope I can make some today. Persistence, when I persist to something that I feel proud of. For example, in the past 20 days, I worked out on 19 days. Even if it doesn't look credible. Don't judge people by appearance, okay? intimate friendship. All right. I have to say, yesterday, a friend of mine said, intimate here means tricky things. I want to say this is like close friend, okay? In my down days, my good friend Shika made an Indian dessert. What's the name?
Kheer.
Okay. Which takes 24 steps to cook. That is pretty touching. I cannot forget about that moment. Okay, achievement. When I made it to something that I have been striving for, why there are only two? Because the bar of something can be defined as achievement is just really high. Pleasant surprise. For example, the moment I find the MPP doorman is actually a philosopher. Next time you feel puzzled about your life, talk to Sam. It helps. All right, the last two, party. Party is still work for me. Sky knows. Last night, I didn't left his apartment until like 3 a.m. I just don't get it. Like how to enjoy in this TNDC, the inability to hear anybody. Because the main source of my happiness is inspiring conversations. And I want you to take away four things from today. The first thing is, happiness means different things for everybody. The fact that I don't enjoy what others enjoy is not the reason that I should feel bad about myself. And secondly, wholehearted happiness requires self-reflection. We are too often urged by the fear of missing out. We sometimes just feed the need of sustainable, fulfilling happiness by just having fun for a couple of hours. It doesn't work well. Probably the more one feels missed out external things, the more one should stop, seek inside what really matters. The third, it's okay, actually good to be unhappy. In Asian culture, being always happy is negative. It means a person is fake, or superficial, or heartless, or dumb. And happiness can be a precious moment for you to reflect, to start doing something new, or do things differently, just as I started tracking my happiness. The last one. How do you answer, how are you doing? Imagine during spring break, you ran into a high school friend in airport. He hugged you and excitedly asked, hey, how have you been? What's going on? How is business school? What would you say? You would say, yeah, it's been great. And then you would say whatever popped to your mind at that moment, which doesn't even matter. We can have far more richer stories to tell if we have things kept on track. Last quarter, I was hosting a coffee chat for a group of class 18 boothies. They are kind of tired of asking questions. And that's when I asked them to pick random number between 1 and 50, which corresponding to my 50 moments, and I share that specific experience and why that matters to me. Next time you catch up with your old friends, you meet a prospective student. How about just picking one or two experiences that matters to you and share why and how it impacted you? Lastly, I don't know what turned you on, but I guess the number two category on my list, pleasant surprise, is great for everybody. So, I bought everyone a banana. I said earlier, I kept my promise. I will make sure everyone has something to take away.